Good morning. The equation for the force of friction is... The force of friction equals the coefficient of friction times the force normal. However, because the force of friction can either be static or kinetic, this equation actually works out to be three different equations.
Flippin' physics!
For kinetic friction, where the two surfaces slide relative to one another, the equation is... The force of kinetic friction equals the coefficient of kinetic friction times the force normal. All I did was add a K subscript for kinetic to both the force of friction and the coefficient of friction. Now, when it comes to static friction, where the two surfaces do not slide relative to one another, it is a bit more complicated. The force of static friction is less than or equal to the coefficient of static friction times the force normal. Therefore, the force of static friction maximum is equal to the coefficient of static friction times the force normal.
Mr. P?
Yes, Billy?
Isn't that second equation for static friction a bit redundant? The equation force of static friction is less than or equal to the coefficient of static friction times force normal already shows us the maximum force of static friction is equal to the coefficient of static friction times force normal. I mean, that's a part of what less than or equal to means, right?
Yes, Billy, you are correct. However, we end up using the equation for the force of static friction maximum very often, and therefore I find that it helps students to understand it better that we have a separate equation for the force of static friction maximum.
Okay.
Now we need an example. Please watch carefully as I apply a force on this book. Bobby, could you please tell me all the forces and their directions which are acting on the book while I am applying this force on it?
There is the force applied to the right, the force of gravity straight down, the force normal up, and the force of friction to the left.
Is that static or kinetic friction?
Static, because the book isn't sliding relative to the table.
Let's talk briefly about the direction of the force of static friction in this free body diagram. Billy, could you please tell me the three things Bobby told us to remember from his video about the direction of the force of friction?
The force of friction is always parallel to the surfaces, is independent of the direction of the force applied, and...
opposes sliding or motion.
That's right, it opposes sliding.
Now clearly the force of static friction is parallel to the table. Now as far as being independent of the direction of the force applied, we're going to talk about that in later lessons, not today. Now, as far as opposing the sliding motion, I want to make sure we understand that. So, Bobby, what does this mean that the book is opposing sliding? I mean, the book doesn't move, does it?
No, the book isn't moving. If there were no friction, the book would slide to our right. So, the force of static friction is preventing the book from sliding to the right. Therefore, the force of static friction needs to be to the left.
That is correct. Now, let's talk about the magnitude of the force of static friction. And that will help us to understand this less than or equal to sign in the equation. Bo, could you please sum the forces in the x direction?
The net force in the x direction equals the force applied minus the force of static friction, which then equals mass times acceleration in the x direction. Because the book is at rest, the acceleration of the book in the x direction is zero. So the right-hand side of the equation equals zero. We can add the force of static friction to both sides. Therefore, the force applied equals the force of static friction. Those two forces are equal in magnitude and opposite in direction.
Great. The magnitude of the force applied is equal to the magnitude of the force of static friction. Now, let's assume that the maximum force of static friction between the book and the table is 1.8 newtons. Now, if I apply a force of 1 newton to the book, class, what is the magnitude of the force of static friction?
1 newton.
Correct. We just showed that the force applied and the force of static friction are equal in magnitude. Therefore, if I applied a force of 1 newton, the force of static friction will also have a magnitude of 1 newton. Now, what if I increase the force I'm applying to the book to 1.5 newtons? Class, what then is the force of static friction?
1.5 newtons.
Correct again. If I apply a force of 1.7 newtons, what is the magnitude of the force of static friction?
1.7 newtons.
still correct. If I apply a force of 1.9 newtons, what is the magnitude of the force of static friction?
1.8?
All right, let's try that one again. If I apply a force of 1.9 newtons, what is the magnitude of the force of static friction?
It's larger than the maximum force of static friction, so the book moves and the friction switches from static to kinetic.
Then there is no force of static friction.
Only kinetic friction. The force of static friction is zero because the book is moving. Correct. The force of static friction increases and decreases in an attempt to prevent the object from moving. In this particular case, once the force applied exceeded the maximum force of static friction, the book began to move and the friction switched from static to kinetic friction. And again, that's what this less than or equal to sign means in the force of static friction equation. That force of static friction increases and decreases in an attempt to prevent the object from moving. Now, let's pretend for a moment that the force of static friction always equaled its maximum value. In this particular case, we're going to pretend that the force of static friction always equals 1.8 newtons. It doesn't adjust, it always equals 1.8 newtons. What would happen then when I apply a force of 1 newton to the book?
The force of static friction would be greater than the force applied, and the book would start to slide to the left, opposite the direction you pushed it.
Yeah, that doesn't make any sense.
Right, that doesn't make any sense. So rather than being a constant number, the force of static friction adjusts in an attempt to prevent the object from moving. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.